हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द ITLS एकेडमी। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फंक्शनल फूड्स एंड द न्यूट्रास्यूटिकल्स। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद दिस। फंक्शनल फूड आर डिफाइंड एज द प्रोडक्ट्स दैट रिजेंबल्स द ट्रेडिशनल फूड बट पोजेस द डेमोंस्ट्रेटेड फिजियोलॉजिकल बेनिफिट्स। हाउएवर द न्यूट्रास्यूटिकल्स आर द कमोडिटीज डिराइव फ्रॉम द फूड्स but are used in the medicinal form of pills, capsules, liquid and again render demonstrated physiological benefits. There are many functional foods and nutraceuticals that are becoming increasingly available in the marketplace, but there is a challenge for the functional food producers because such products should address the issues of sensory acceptability, which is not necessary for the nutraceuticals or pharmaceutical product. Functional foods has grown enormously over the past two decades to include additives like soya protein, collagen, spirulina in snacks, bars, drinks, mixes, pastas, cereals and powders, to namely only a few. So basically, clearly it's all foods are functional as they provide taste, aroma, nutritive value. Within the last decade, however, the term functional as it applies to food has adopted a different connotation, that of providing an additional physiological benefit beyond that of the meeting versus nutritional needs. So the main focus of such product is to improve health and reduce disease risk through the prevention. The main difference of this category with the pharmaceutical is that they are multi-targeted mixtures and present at low concentration. While if we talk about the pharmaceuticals, they are generally uni-targeted, pure compound and consist of the heavy dose, high dose use. So let's go through the definition of what we are going to study today in today's lecture. First, let me define you the nutraceuticals. Nutraceuticals are naturally derived bioactive compounds that are found in the foods, dietary supplements and herbal products, and have health promoting, disease preventing and the medicinal products also. Now let's define the functional food. Functional foods are foods which contain an ingredient that gives that food health promoting properties over and above its usual nutritional value. For example, the probiotic yogurt. Next is another and somewhat related to these topics is the dietary supplements. Dietary supplements look like drugs and are made from the food isolated nutrients of food like substances to augment the health. So beginning with the functional food. Foods or dietary components that may provide a health benefit beyond basic nutrition. Foods that by virtue of physiologically active food component and provide again the health benefit. These are the similar in appearance to conventional foods consumed as a part of normal or usual diet with the demonstrated physiological benefits, or reduce the risk of chronic diseases and beyond basic nutritional functions, and including the maintenance of gut too. So functional food embraces the edible component with the potential to nourish as well as to improve the antioxidant, mutagenic combating and immune status of the body too. These foods fortified with the add or concentrated ingredients to functional level, which improves the health or performance. It includes enriched cereals, sport drinks, bars. These foods can have some identified value leading to the health benefit, including the reduced risk of diseases of a person consuming it. Fruits with fiber and antioxidant, fortified foods formulated ready to drink beverages are some of the functional foods. So functional foods present either inherently in the food or via fortification that can promote the growth and development and enhancement performance and enhance performance, and they also provides the body with the required amount of vitamins, fats, protein, carbohydrates, etc. that is needed for the healthy survival. So all foods serve as a function, example, to sustain life. But so-called functional food that includes whole foods and fortified, enriched or enhanced foods that have a potentially beneficial effect on health when consuming as a part of a varied diet on a regular basis at effective level. So it is a working definition as a working definition of a functional food is any food that's enriched or enhanced to benefit overall nutrition. Moving towards the next slide is the functional food source. Means what are the sources from where we get the functional food? So it depends on the two properties, that is the functional food that is derived from the plant source, and next is the functional food that is derived from the animal. If we talk about the functional food from the plant source, a plant-based diet can reduce the risk of chronic diseases, particularly the cancer, as we know. It is now clear that there are components in the plant-based diet other than the traditional nutrients that can reduce the cancer risk. And more than a dozen classes of these biological active plant chemicals, now known as the phytochemicals. If we talk about the sources, we can take the oats. Oats products are a widely studied dietary source of the cholesterol-lowering soluble fiber glucan. There is now significant scientific agreement that consumption of these particular plant food can reduce total as well as the low density lipoprotein cholesterol, thereby reducing the risk of coronary heart diseases. Next category is the soya. Soya has been in the spotlight during the 1990s. Now, not only is soya as a high quality protein as assessed by the FDA protein digestibility corrected amino acid score method, it is now thought to play preventive and therapeutic roles in the cardiovascular diseases, that is the CVD, cancer, osteoporosis, and the elevation of menopause symptoms. So next is the flax seed. Among the major seeds oil, flax seeds oil contains the most, up to about 57% of the omega-3 fatty acids, linolenic acid. Recent research, however, has focused more specifically on fiber-associated compounds known as the lignans. Consumption of flax seed has also been shown to reduce the total and low density cholesterol in humans. Next is the tomatoes. If you talk about the tomatoes, the selected by eating well magazines in 1997 vegetable of the year, tomatoes have received significant attention within the last 3 years because of interest in lycopene, the primary carotenoid found in this fruit, and its role has a great role in cancer risk reduction. Next is your garlic. Garlic is likely the herb most widely quoted in the literature for the medicinal properties. The purported health benefit of garlic are numerous, including the cancer, chemopreventive, antibiotic, antihypertensives, and cholesterol lowering properties. Next is your broccoli and other cruciferous vegetables. Epidemiologically, evidence has associated the frequent consumption of cruciferous vegetables with decreased cancer risk. Other sources are citrus fruit, cranberry tea, wines, grapes, etc. Next is the functional food that is derived from the animal source. In this, we talk about the beef. Beef is an anti-carcinogenic fatty acids known as the conjugated linoleic acid CLA was first isolated from the grilled beef in 1987. The next is the dairy product. There is no doubt that dairy products are functional food. They are one of the best source of calcium as an essential nutrient which can prevent the osteoporosis and possibly the colon cancer. In addition to the calcium, however, recent research has focused specifically on other components in the dietary product, particularly the fermented dairy products known as the probiotics. The probiotics are defined as live microbial feed supplement which beneficially affect the host animal by improving its intestinal microbial balance. The last is the fish. From fish we get the omega-3 fatty acids and they are essential class of polyunsaturated fatty acids, the PUFAs, derived primarily from the fresh oil. And it acts as a functional food source and very important for the human growth. Okay, functional food products. Functional food products include most early development of functional foods were those of fortified with the vitamins or minerals such as the vitamin C, E, folic acid, zinc, iron and calcium. Subsequently, the focus shifted to foods fortified with various micronutrients such as omega-3 fatty acids, phytosterol and soluble fiber to promote good health or to prevent disease such as the cancer. Now, as we know, the more sources we have talked about in the previous slide that focuses mainly on the treatment on the cancer and various cholesterol related diseases, that coronary related diseases. So functional food somehow is related in prevention of these types of diseases. Most recently, food companies have taken further step to develop food products that offers the multiple health benefits in a single food. So functional food products are not homogeneously scattered over all segments of the food and drink markets and consumer health concern, and product preference may vary between the market. These products have been mainly launched in the dairy confectionery, soft drinks, bakery and baby food market, etc. Next is your functional food development, means how the functional foods are developed. Here is a diagram showing the process of functional food and health promotion cycle of source, which relates with the concept of generation, novel ideas, product development, efficacy and safety, evidence, publication, media and health, consumer buying perception and industrial growth. Taking the first point as the concept testing. Concept testing tells that the process through which innovation in nutritional science occurs developed through the intersecting alliance of various stockholders as depicted in the figure, involved as a research, industry, regulatory and consumer sector interests, etc. Next is your product development. It involves the develop a real world test product that embraces that concept. For instance, production of the probiotic enriched yogurt, a cheese enriched with the omega-3 fats. These are the product development, the reality and the prototype evolution. Next is the efficacy and safety that involves the cell, animal, human studies. Expression of a nutrition health concept through a development of a product needs to be followed by verification that the product will mirror the original concept through the testing of biological efficacy. Efficacy assessment is an essential element of establishing the credibility of functional food entities performed using in vitro or in vivo systems. Evidence also need to be provided by parallel studies conducted across several jurisdictions and conducted in both the academic as well as the private sector institutional laboratories. Next is your publication. Publication for required for dissemination of biological efficacy data is through publication in peer-reviewed journals. it is equally important that negative as well as positive efficacy and safety rules be disseminated through peer reviewed publication in order to provide a balanced evaluation of the true merits of that ingredient. Next is your media activity plus health claim and regulatory reviews. So health claim and regulatory reviews involves the communication of health messages generated through the active research and regulatory review regulatory review is required in order to translate peer-reviewed published data supporting the efficacy and safety of a given bioactive product with a novel food matrix or capsules into policy changes consistent with the approving products for the sale of the functional food products. Next, cycle tells about the industry growth. In industry growth, the securing specific messages on the foods attesting to their health benefits represent a vital part of the cycle of moving a functional food from the concept of a marketing success story. Given that the consumers are both interested and informed about the food that confers the health benefits beyond simply providing nutrients. So the presence of an informative authoritative claim on a food will stimulate the market share penetration of that product within its sector. So here is the cycle and how it is correlated, I have told you. Next, let's move on to the nutraceuticals. Nutraceuticals deals with the products that is prepared from the food but sold in the form of pills or powder or any other medicinal form not usually associated with the food. It is demonstrated to have a physiological benefit of or provide protection against the chronic diseases. Nutraceuticals are distinct from the functional food. As the name suggests that it is a combination of nutrition required for the health plus the pharmaceuticals, that is generally the remedy for the sickness or injury, and the combination of both gives us the nutraceutical, that is the preventive medical approach. So nutraceuticals is a pharmaceutical grade and standardized nutrient. These are regulated by FDA under the authority of the Federal Food, Drug and Cosmetic Act. Nutraceuticals are the product extracted, purified, produced from a plant, animal or marine source or produced from the dried powders, pressed plant material and demonstrated to have physiological benefits or to provide protection against the chronic diseases. Reasons for popularity of nutraceuticals and functional food means why they are required. These are required because it provides an increase in public health consciousness, an aging population, escalating health care cost, recent advances in research and technology, changes in the government regulation and accountability, expansion of the global marketplace, a sympathetic media. Science-based evidence is contributing to the popularity of the functional food. So these are the reasons why the nutraceuticals and functional foods are quite common and famous amongst the people. Okay, why nutraceuticals? Okay, next is the why nutraceuticals, why it is required. Many diets are rich in phenolic component and are daily consumed by human beings. They rarely have any side effect and they have relatively long half shelf life. They can be easily absorbed in the intestine after ingestion and they are easily available without prescription. Many people believe this approach is more natural than using the prescription drug, that is the chemotherapy. So people feel dietary supplement will help them feel stronger and healthier, give them more energy and prevent illness. Some people turn to these products when they feel standard treatment for their specific illness have failed and convenient for today's lifestyle. So this is why the nutraceuticals are very common and are in utilization by many of us in our societies. ओके द नेक्स्ट इज द डायट्री सप्लीमेंट. डायट्री सप्लीमेंट इज अ प्रोडक्ट दैट कंटेन्स न्यूट्रिएंट्स डिराइव फ्रॉम द फूड प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर कंसंट्रेटेड इन लिक्विड और कैप्सूल फॉर्म. एंड द डायट्री सप्लीमेंट हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन एक्ट DSHEA of 1994 defined generally what constitute a dietary supplement. So a dietary supplement is a product taken by mouth that contain a dietary ingredient intended to supplement the diet. The dietary ingredient in this product may include the vitamin, minerals, herbs or other botanical amino acids, substances such as enzymes, organs, tissues, glandulars and metabolites. So dietary supplements can also be extract or concentrates and may be found in many forms such as the tablet, capsules, soft gels, gels, caps, liquid or powders. So in response to mounting confusion about the claim made by the Dietary Supplement Producer, Congress passed in Dietary Supplement Health and Education Act of 1994, DSHEA, which determined that vitamins, extract and other nutrient-based compound would be regulated as food rather than the drugs, which are subject to extensive trial and may make claim as their efficacy, whereas supplement may not. So it is defined as DSHEA defines the dietary supplement as a product that is intended to supplement the diet which contains one or more of the following dietary ingredients, which includes the vitamin, minerals, herbs, other botanical amino acids, or dietary substance of supplement the diet, increasing the total daily intake, or a concentrate metabolite constituent extract. A combination of these ingredients is ingested in pills, capsules, tablets or liquid form, is not represented for use as a conventional food or as the sole item of a meal or a diet, and is labeled as a dietary supplement. So this is what a dietary supplement, which is somehow related with the functional food and the nutraceuticals. So the playing field is the wide for dietary supplement, which can be an isolated vitamin like capsules of vitamin E, an extract like that of the plant Gingko biloba, or a fatty acids like omega 3. So at last I would conclude that the nutraceuticals and functional food generates one of the most promising and dynamic development segment in the food industry, increasing the consumer awareness in the combination with new advances in various scientific domains is supporting the inflow of the functional food. In the case of a successful product development, attention should be paid both in the consumer demand as well as in the technical conditions. Furthermore, the legislation background should not be neglected, and consumer acceptance is the key success factor. Consumer acceptance is determined by the factor like primary health concern, consumer familiarities with the functional food concepts, with the functional ingredient, the nature of the carrier product, manner of the health effect, communication. That is why it is very, nutraceuticals and functional food are very quite much common in now up to date generation. Main conditions for acceptance of the functional food is pertaining to taste, beside products, quality, price, convenience and trustworthiness and health claim. By purchasing functional food, is in general consumer may achieve a modern and positive impression of themselves. These products provide consumers a modern way to follow a healthy lifestyle, which differs from the conventionally health diet defined by the nutrition experts, or a balanced diet we can say. So I hope you have gone through the various types of diet today I have discussed, that is about the functional food and the nutraceuticals and the dietary supplements. For more information about this topic, please log on to our website www.itlsacademy.com, and also follow us on Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, LinkedIn. And yes, do not forget to subscribe our channel ITLS Academy at YouTube. Thank you.